Springtime is here, which means it's time to dust off that mower, get back out in the yard, and work on that beautiful lawn. And in this video, I'm going to give you 5 tips for proper mowing that are going to do just that, get you a thick, green, beautiful lawn. Tip number 1 is something that I see a lot of people making the mistake with. I hear landscape companies and people up early in the morning cutting their grass, knowing that it's really wet. That dew on the grass, or if there's been rainfall of any kind, mowing your grass when it's wet is a no-no. And there's multiple reasons. The first one is because when you're cutting the grass when it's wet, it's not going to stand up the way that it should. The way that a rotary mower is built is to allow airflow to go through the deck of that mower, which stands the grass blades up, and then that sharp blade cuts the blades of grass nice and even. If you mow when it's wet, the deck of that mower gets gunked up full of grass and all kinds of other things, which are going to restrict the airflow. It's not going to lift the grass up as much, and the grass tends to bend over and fall over when it's wet. So mowing when the grass is dry is something that's really important to do, and it's going to help the overall appearance of your grass. Step number 2 is to follow what's called the 1/3 rule. If you know anything about lawn care, you've probably heard this before, but if you're new, this might be new to you. The 1/3 rule basically means you don't want to cut off more than 1/3 of the grass leaf at one time. So for example, if your grass is 3 inches long, you don't want to cut more than 1 inch off of that grass. If you do, the grass plant starts to go into shock mode. It's not as strong, and it's going to focus its energy into surviving instead of growing and thriving. So make sure when you're mowing, measure the grass if you need to. Most people don't go out with a tape measure, but you could if you wanted to. Measure the grass, see how long it is, and then you can measure what your height of cut is on your mower by taking either a tape measure or a ruler and measuring from the ground to the bottom of your mower deck. That's going to tell you what your height of cut is. And again, follow that 1/3 rule and make sure that you're not cutting off more than 1/3 of the grass plant. Now, if you're in a situation where you've had rain all week and you can't mow for whatever reason, you may need to raise up your mowing height for a mow or two and gradually work it back down to get it where you want it to be. But if you cut off 1/3 of the grass blade, the plant is going to love that. Anytime you're mowing, it causes some stress to the grass, but if you're mowing frequently and just hitting the tip of the grass off, the plant is going to love that, and it's going to put more energy toward tillering or creating more blades of grass. When that happens, your grass thickens up, it gets wider, and it fills in, and before you know it, you've got a thick carpet of beautiful grass. Something else to consider when you're mowing is what is the ideal height of cut for your type of grass. Not all grass is the same, and there's certain height of cut preferences for different types of grass, which I'm going to put right here. Now, with that being said, if you want to mow your grass a little bit lower, like I've taken my backyard and I've brought it down lower than the ideal height of cut, but it's still thriving because I've trained my grass to do that. Over a year, I took my grass from about 3 inches down to 2.5 to 2, and I eventually brought it all the way down to about a half inch, which is not typically recommended. And if you cut at that low of a height, one, you need a special mower, which is called a reel mower, and two, it requires some more fertilization. You're more prone to get disease, but it's what I really enjoy, so it's what I've gone with in my backyard. My front yard, I keep a little bit longer, around 2 to 2.5 inches, so that's like your more traditional lawn that you would have in the average American home. This last step I've saved for the last on purpose because it's probably the most important step when it comes to proper mowing, and that's cutting with a well-balanced, sharp blade. A lot of times people get their blade sharpened, but they don't take the time to balance it. And if you've ever seen a ceiling fan that's not balanced, it wobbles all over the place. And a mower blade that isn't balanced ends up doing the exact same thing, which ends up giving you a cut that's not as clean as it should be. So taking the time to sharpen your blade and balance it is the last and most important step when it comes to that thick, green, beautiful lawn that you want. So a couple helpful things when you are sharpening your blade, there's a few different ways to do that. One is you can use an angle grinder. An angle grinder is a great way to sharpen that blade. If you use it along with a vise, it makes it really easy. And something that's also helpful when it comes to sharpening your blade is counting the amount of passes you go on each side. If you do 5 passes on one side and you think it's pretty sharp, try to do 5 on the other side. If it needs a little bit of adjustment, try to do the same amount of passes on each side. Also, a hand file works too. Another way that you can sharpen your blade is by using a bench grinder. A bench grinder is my favorite way to sharpen a mower blade, and it turns out to be really nice. You can just slide it right along that guide, and that bench grinder does all the work for you. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it, and I'll see you next time.